Hi, my name is Patrick Reagan. Welcome to the operating systems Windows architecture, where we can go depth of Windows by looking at the architecture of Windows 10 and 11. In part two, this video will cover how Windows manages its memory, including physical memory and virtual memory. It also describes a heap, a process, thread, and handle, and how they relate to the running programs. The video finishes with discussing dynamic link libraries, file explorer, the registry, Windows services, and remote procedure calls. As with most of my videos, there are questions at the end of the video. Physical memory is the amount of physical RAM available in the computer. Virtual memory is used as an extension of physical memory when there's not enough RAM to store data and process requests. In Windows, virtual memory exists as physical hidden file on the hard drive called a page file, pagefile.sys. Remember, since virtual memory is stored on disk, it is much slower than physical memory. Memory, physical and virtual, are divided into pages. A 4 kilobyte blocks that can be reserved, committed, or free. A page table is the data structure used by Windows to keep track of a mapping between virtual addresses used by a process and the corresponding physical addresses in the system's memory. A page table entry, or PTE, is an entry in the page table that stores information about a particular page of memory. The 64-bit architecture permits 2 to the 64th power, or about 16 exabytes of address space. However, Windows 11 Enterprise and Windows 11 Pro for workstations can only recognize up to 6 terabytes of memory, while Windows Server 2022 Data Center can access up to 64 terabytes. Free memory is the pages of the virtual address space available for the process use. In this case, when a user initializes a process, most of the pages in the virtual addresses are free memory. Committed memory is processes actively use this type of memory, and it consists of physical RAM and page files. It is a promise from the OS that it will be backed by RAM or paging files. Process reserve memory is the amount of memory reserved by a process for its own use. This memory isn't necessary, but is usually reserved when a process initializes. Working set is the amount of RAM used by a single process. This includes private and shareable memory. Windows use demand paging. Demand paging has data copied from virtual memory to physical memory only when required or demanded by the CPU. If physical memory is full, Windows will have to move files from the physical memory to the virtual memory to make room for the new demanded page. A page fault is an interruption that occurs when software attempts to access a memory block not currently stored in the system's RAM. This exception tells the operating system to find the block in virtual memory, device storage or drive, and sends it to RAM. Most page faults are normal background processes. An invalid page fault is when a program tries to access a memory address that doesn't exist. Windows may terminate that program, resulting in a crash. Heap is an area of memory reserved for data that is created when a program is executed. Each process has a process heap that is created when the process is started and is never deleted so long as the process is running. All the threads in the process will share the heap. By default, the heap is 1 megabyte in size. If the process needs more memory, the heap will expand. A process is an isolated memory structure which supports an application in OS hardware and software. A Windows process contains one or more threads. A thread is a stream of sequential machine code instructions that the processor executes. A thread is created when a program or process needs to do several things at once in a multitasking way. Examples include spell checking the background in Microsoft Word, or other cells recalculate when you enter data into a spreadsheet. An application may speed its operation by using multiple threads, each performing an isolated task by running their stream of instructions through a different CPU execution unit simultaneously. Handles are how processes talk to compute resources. A handle is a logical association with a shared resource like a file, window, memory location, etc. It handles access to a resource such as a file memory location. For example, if you ever tried deleting a file and you get the error that says it may be open in another program, that's because a program on your computer has the handle open on that file. A handle leak is a type of software issue that can, in extreme cases, destabilize a system. It is caused by a program requesting the handle to a resource and failing to deallocate it when the program is done with the resource. A dynamic link library, or DLL file, is a type of file that contains instructions and data that other programs can call upon to perform certain functions. It allows large programs to be broken into smaller components or modules. Because the modules are separate, the load time of the program is faster. A module is only loaded when that functionality is requested. It allows several programs can share the functionality of a DLL file simultaneously. For example, in Windows operating systems, the comdlg32.dll file performs common dialog box related functions. While most dynamic link libraries end in the file extension .dll, others may use ActiveX controls .ocx, control panel files .cpl, or device driver files .drv. Unlike applications, these cannot be directly executed, but an application will load them as when they are required or all at once during startup. In the same way that an application requires a DLL file might be dependent on other DLL files itself. Updates are easier to apply to each module without affecting other parts of the program. File Explorer, formerly known as Windows Explorer, is the file management graphical application used by Windows to browse and manage files and folders. File Explorer runs in the background and provides your taskbar and your desktop. File Explorer enables a search feature that provides an advanced search mechanism that allows you to search for any files or data stored on your device based on various attributes. File Explorer allows copying and transferring two or more files simultaneously within a single window or screen. You can pause, stop, or cancel this process of copying the files. File Explorer can be extended to support non-default functionality by means of the Windows Shell extensions. Shell extensions are COM objects that plug the extended functionality into Windows Explorer. Shell extensions can be in the form of shell extension handlers, toolbars, or even namespace extensions that allow certain folders or even non-file system objects such as the images scanned by scanner, to be presented as a special folder. In a screenshot, you can see tree size, mcp.hc, 7-zip, WinRAR, and Norton 360, which are extensions in File Explorer. In this screenshot, you can also see that the same computer also has Office 365, which added extensions to File Explorer. The registry in Microsoft Windows is a hierarchy database used to store information that is necessary to configure the system for one or more uses, applications, services, and hardware devices. It contains information that Windows continually references during operation. The colors of defaults used in Windows in the background, such as profiles for each user, the application installed on the computer, and the types of documents for each can create, the property sheet settings for folders, application icons, what hardware exists on the system, and the ports that are being used. The main branches of the registry are called hives. Most PCs have five of them. HKEY classes root keeps track of default file associations. This is how your computer knows how to open a Word document file or an Excel document file. HKEY current user contains settings specific to your username in Windows. HKEY local machine contains passwords, boot files, software installation files, and security settings. The hive is abbreviated as HKLM and is the most critical hive. HKEY users is like the current user hive, except it's for when more than one user is logged into the server or computer. HKEY current config is a real-time measurement of different hardware activities. Information in this hive isn't saved permanently to the registry. The hive that makes up the registry hives are stored in multiple files on the hard drive. Most of them are in the Windows System 32 config folder. The user's profile files are located in the users/profiles folder under each individual user folder. The registry hive locations can actually be seen by looking at the hive list in the registry. Registry keys are containers that act like folders, with values or subkeys contained within them. Registry values are similar to files, which are the settings themselves. Key settings are very granular, consisting of numbers and codes that dictate window settings and behaviors. For example, how fast a letter repeatedly appears on the screen when you hold down its key. If you change the settings in the control panel, the value will change in the registry. Much like files and folders, registry entries are objects which have permissions. Windows services are a core component of the Microsoft Windows operating system and enables the creation and management of long-running processes. Unlike regular software that is launched by the end user and only runs when the user is logged on, Windows services can start without user intervention and may continue to run long after the user has logged off. Prefetch and Superfetch services, SysMain, speeds up operating systems and application startup by caching to RAM frequently used files, libraries, and application components determined by monitoring applications' usage and behavior. Background Intelligent Transfer Service, or BITS, facilitates throttled, prioritized, and asynchronous file transfer between machines via idle bandwidth. It plays a key role in the delivery of software updates from servers to clients, as well as the transfer of files on Microsoft's instant messaging applications. DNS Client Service, or DNS Cache, is a service that resolves domain names to IP addresses and locally caches this data. DHCP Client registers and updates IP addresses and DNS records for the computer. BitLocker Drive Encryption Services provides secure startup for the operating system, as well as full volume encryption for OS, fixed, and removable volumes. Cryptographic Services is a Microsoft Windows feature that encrypts and decrypts data on storage devices, which can be used for user authentication and archival encryption or decryption. The Print Spooler spools print jobs and handles interaction with the printer. Remote Desktop Services, previously called Terminal Services, allows users to connect interactively to a remote computer via remote desktop client. Task Scheduler enables a user to configure and schedule automated tasks on the computer. Workstation Services allows Windows to access network resources, including shared folders and printers, using the Server Message Block, or SMB, protocol. Server Service provides network resources such as shared folders and printers. Remember, even Windows 10 and 11 clients can provide shared folders and printers to servers and clients. NetLogon Service maintains a secure channel between the computer and the domain controller for authenticating users and services. Without this service, the computer may not authenticate users and services, and the domain controller cannot register DNS records. Remote Procedure Call, or RPC, is a software communications protocol that one program can use to request a service from a program located in another computer on a network without having to understand the network's details. The Remote Procedures Call is the service control manager for COM and DCOM servers. Many services depend on RPC to function. Microsoft COM, Component Object Model, enables inter-process communications between software components. It uses a client-server architecture. A COM client connects to a COM server. The COM server has COM objects with several interfaces that the client can use. COM Plus is the enhanced version of COM that provides better security and improved performance. When COM was made available for components on two different computers in the network, it became DCOM, which is short for Distributed Component Object Model. The DCOM protocol uses RPC to expose application objects while handling the low-level details of a network protocol. Question: what type of memory that uses disk space to increase available memory? Answer, virtual memory. Question, what is the isolated memory structure that represents a running program? Answer, process. Question, what file is the type of file that contains instructions and data that other programs can call upon to perform certain functions? Answer, dynamic link library. Question, what is the Windows core component that enables the creation and management of a long-running process? Answer, Windows service. Question, what is the software protocol that allows one program to request a service from a computer on the network? Answer, RPC. For more information, visit these sites. In summary, virtual memory is used as an extension of physical memory when there is not enough RAM to store data and process requests. In Windows, virtual memory exists as a physical hidden file on the hard disk called a paging file, pagefile.sys. Windows uses demand paging, which has data copied from virtual memory to physical memory only when required or demanded by the CPU. Memory, physical and virtual, are divided into pages, 4 kilobyte blocks. A process is an isolated memory structure which supports an application, OS hardware, and software. A thread is a stream of sequential machine code instructions that the processor executes. A dynamic link library, or DLL file, is a type of file that contains instructions and data that other programs can call upon to perform certain functions. File Explorer, formerly known as Windows Explorer, is the file management graphical application used by Windows to browse and manage files and folders. The registry in Microsoft Windows is a hierarchy database used to store information that is necessary to configure the system for one or more users, applications, services, and hardware devices. Windows services are a core component of the Microsoft Windows operating system and enables the creation and management of long-running processes. Remote Procedure Call, or RPC, is a software communications protocol that one program can use to request a service from a program located in another computer on a network without having to understand the network details. Thank you for watching this video. This completes the Windows Architecture series. In the future, look for additional videos on Windows. Thank you.